Hey everybody, welcome to my live stream today, episode number 18. It's gonna be super chill, changing my atmosphere a little bit. Hey Janelle, how are you? Hola Hugo, ¿cómo estás? So thank you guys for stopping in today on episode number 18 of Parking Lot Confessions with Mel. I just wanted to chill out with everybody today, see what you guys are up to, what you want to talk about, like for 30 minutes maybe. Hi Robert, how are you? Did you post more things in Marketplace today? Hey Ali, how are you? So today is just like a chill out one, just to talk. As you can see, I have new lights in the background. Trying to improve a little bit. Just a different one because today's Friday. So woohoo! Hey Phil, how are you? So I'm just here having a good time with you guys. Just a regular Friday night. Just wanted to talk about, I don't know if it's too loud. I don't know if the other music is too loud. Hopefully it's not too loud. Yeah, I think that's better. Let me get this closer. You like my new lights? I know, right? So cool. I even have a strobe light. Look. Yeah, but that might tire you a little bit. I just need to get like another different light. I think I know what light to get. I'm trying some new stuff. Hold on. Let me see how bright this makes me. Do I look better with this light now? Having the other background? Let me see. Is it good? Far, distance, less? It looks funny with all these lights on top of me. I don't know how it looks. Why does it always tell me this? This is so crazy. Hey Holly, hey Steve, how are you? So I wanted to talk to you guys about something that I learned this morning from the Rise and Grind show. He shared this podcast about calling, I forgot the name. It's called Fearless, Mindless, Fearless, something like that. I forgot already. Fearless Motivation. And let me tell you, that podcast is fire. I have listened to already like 12 tracks of that podcast, and I can tell you that I have like thought about so many things and realized that I don't have a purpose. I really don't have a purpose in life because all of my goals are set up to materialistic things. And happiness as well, but there is not that fuel that will drive me every day to do the best of myself. So I saw, I think it was one that were talking about your beliefs and your reasons, like your why. So I did realize that my why is gonna be, hey Michael, is gonna be my family, because I support my grandparents and my mother. From my country, I'm from Colombia, so I help them out, you know, with almost everything. So for me, I think my purpose will be my family, will be being a better person. I know, right? It's amazing. It was super cool. Hey Michael, so for me, that purpose, I felt bad when I thought I knew my purpose. Because I completely thought I knew my purpose. But now, this morning, I was like, oh, shoot. Like, wow. What is really my purpose? And now I realized, like, yep, my purpose is my family. I gotta fight for it. I gotta go for it. I gotta keep, you know, helping them out no matter what. So I finally found it. So that's gonna be my fuel every day, because they say that if you don't have motivation and if you don't have that, like, that fire in you, that's why you get bored, that's why you're lazy, that's why you don't accomplish things in life. So for me, one of the reasons that I see this is like very strong is that fire, that fire that you have for something, or that motivation, cannot go weak because it's something that you really want. It only will go weak if you really don't want that. You know what I mean? Because if it's something that you just see it and you get like tired of it, that's not your purpose. So you gotta sit again, write in a piece of paper, and, you know, bring out a goal. So my purpose, like my why, will be my family. And then I will start accomplishing small goals until I get to the big goal, and then I'll be good. If I reach that big goal, it could be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 goals, I will try to reach another big goal, and so on and so on and so on. Drive your why, yeah, we need all kind of goals. Yeah, so it says that if you don't have a goal, that's bad. Like, you have to have goals. So I'm actually gonna write them down. I have a little notebook here. It says Love On. It's from Christ Fellowship, I think it is. They gave it to us when I did my first course. So I'm gonna write everything down, just like, I don't know, Robert, are you in the group Rise and Grind? Do you watch him in the morning or no? Glenn Lundy? Because let me tell you, it's super, super cool to watch him every morning. Yeah, so I'm gonna start writing my goals, my thankful notes, and everything like that, so I can feel like I'm super blessed. You know what I mean? So yeah, who is watching with me? Hey, Janelle is to here. Hey, Andrew, how are you? I don't know if it looks better if I leave it on or off. My why is my wife and kids, and to be able to have her be at home with our children. Aw, that's super sweet. Yep, that is amazing. That is amazing. Yeah, I started seeing that because a lot of people started posting, hi, Abed, how are you? They started posting pictures of their kids and their family, and everybody just talks about that. Their why will be their family. I think family is very important. If you have a happy family, I'm pretty sure that even though you have a stressful day at work, when you come back home, you will feel like, oh, I'm coming back to my family. So you're cool, you're happy, there's this motivation, you got kids waiting for you, etc., etc. I don't have a family, I don't have a husband, I don't have a boyfriend, I only have a cat. So for me, it's sometimes a little difficult to come home by myself. So that's why I like to do these lives, because it helps me kind of like interact with other people. And you know, just pass the time and have a little chill out. Hi, Tom, how are you? Thank you for joining. So yeah, that's what I think. Who is still here? Janelle, what is your why? Can you share us your why, Janelle? I want to know your why. I don't know if the music is too loud. Let me know if the music is okay, if you guys like it. I think it's very chill out. If you don't want to share it, you know, I understand. Or maybe you're typing something long. Ooh, of course, your kids and your family. How many kids do you have, Janelle? Hey, Glenn, we were talking about you. We were talking about how amazing your Rise and Grind episode was this morning. Hey, Manny, how are you? Thank you guys for joining. That is super cool. Hi, Manny, how was your day? I am just chilling with all of you. It's nothing serious here. We're just talking about our purpose. What is your why? What is your purpose? Things that are turning. Oh yeah, I did see your twins. So beautiful. Wow. Who would have thought you had all those children, Janelle? That's awesome. I don't have any, so I just have a little cat. If that's considered a child. But yeah. That's awesome. Yeah, that's great. Yeah, I was telling them, Glenn, about that fearless motivation that you post this morning. I've been hearing the whole podcast, like the whole day, like filling up my brain with all that stuff. And I noticed that I don't have a purpose. So I figured out that my purpose is my family. So I'm actually going to start doing my notebook and my thankful notes and my goals, because I did not do that yet. Because trust me, it's so hard to wake up at 5:30 in the morning. It's really hard. I mean, I know some people can do it, but I guess consistency and habits will make me like a little stronger to wake up every morning and just enjoy like really waking up at that time. I have a 5-year-old son, a 3-year-old daughter, and 1 baby girl. Wow, that's awesome, Robert. Yeah, God hasn't blessed me yet with none of those things, but he has blessed me with a good job, a place to live, my family. So hopefully one day I'll have that little picture with all my people and my big family. Hi, Jorge. How are you? Hi, Jonathan Castro. Hola, Zuli. ¿Cómo estás? Yeah, you have a big gang. You have 5 boys, Manny? Woo! That's a lot of people. That's a lot of people. So one of what would you think that would be like, how do you say this? What would you think is a easy goal to accomplish? Meaning like, what do you guys have in mind to do in life that is in a short term that will benefit you, that will make you happy? Is it job wise? Is it family wise? Is it money wise? Is it traveling? What would it be? Yeah, I know, it's gonna be so awesome. Anytime soon. Hey, Megan. Hey, Rob Kimball. How are you people? Thank you for joining. Yeah, this thing is gonna get us like. Yeah, for example, in my case, for me, a short goal will be helping others. That is something that I'm doing right now. So that's something that I think that if I keep doing the things with social media and helping people earn more money online, doing their cars, I think that is something that people will remember me in case something happens. You know, if I go bye-byes, I know a lot of people know that I did it in a humble way and to help out people, you know, succeed and get their levels up and their numbers up. What are you doing? No. No. That's not for playing. Ew. Bad boy. Sorry, my cat. I said no. 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 Be a good boy. Sorry, guys. Hoping others is great. Hoping others. Yeah, I know. Hold on, guys. Let me bring something that will make him stop doing that. See if he keeps doing that. Yes, I like the fact, because like a lot of people that are like, you know, like in, how do you say this, like in bigger positions than me, ask me why I do it for free, and I don't even need to charge anybody. I mean, everybody needs money and things like that, but I think just helping others and helping the community grow will be much better, because I'm not the complete expert in the matter, but I'm really good at it. So at least if I can help and teach others, that would be awesome. That's the thing, that's one of my main goals, helping. Hey Josh, hey Boo, how are you? So that's what I think. Let me see if I can get this higher. Yep. It comes in God's time. Hey CJ, how are you? Sorry I didn't say hello to you. Let me see who else is here. So that's what I think. I don't know what you guys think. What are your small goals? One of the things that I would love to do is to work remotely, meaning that I don't have to go to an office or anything. I can be anywhere in the world and I can still sell cars. That'd be awesome. And it is possible if you have the right tools and the right people to buy the cars out of auction. You can sell anything. You can just telemarket and sell it. It will be hard because I think it's kind of like a hard profession because you have more rejection through the phone because nobody's watching you. But I believe if we can get people to get into videos and FaceTimes and see us face to face and see my personality and see the personality of the other person, you can tell in their eyes the way they speak. Even remotely, we can actually sell cars. That's one of the things that I think will be very awesome in the future. I don't know. I am doing great, CJ. Thank you for stopping by. This is like a really random live that I do like once in the moon on a Friday or Saturday. So I hope you enjoy it. We are talking about our purpose in life. What is your purpose, CJ? I'll put it like this so I can see who's on. Wait, oh yeah, she did. Hey Boo, what's your purpose in life? Let me wave to you. Let me wave to Josh. If you have any requests of music, let me know.
This is quite true, but it applies to everything else as well. The person you will be in the future is based on everything you do today, the people you hang around with, but more so the people you listen to,
the
opinions you believe, the books you read, or the videos you watch. All the information you take in, positive or negative, will affect your future. The workouts you do or don't do, that will show up in the future. The foods you eat today will affect your future on a visual and energy level. The same is true with your thoughts and information. What you feed your mind will shape your future. If all you do is take in garbage, guess what your future is going to be made up of? Commit to feed your mind with successful thoughts and surround yourself with those who have the same ambition. It doesn't matter where you get your information from. You may read. You may get it from podcasts or videos. It doesn't matter. Just make sure you keep feeding your mind every day. Your future self is begging you to show some discipline.
This is so
your future
powerful.
Self is begging you not to be like the rest, to learn more than the rest, to work
hey,
harder
Carlos,
and smarter than the rest.
Estás?
Your future self is begging you to do the work now so you can enjoy
what
later. If you don't feed your mind with success, it will rot with mediocrity. What you do every day will dictate your future. What you want out of life, you must put it in. If you want success, put it in there. If you want health and fitness, put it in. If you want peace and happiness, put it in. Your actions will equal your results. My mind is strong. I am strong. My thoughts are strong. My beliefs are strong. My life is strong. They say I can't. I can.
They say
I won't.
I will. I love it.
They say I'm not. I am. I am limitless. I am. I am. There's nothing I cannot be. Nothing I cannot do.
Give me the chills.
Nothing I cannot have. In my mind, there are no limits. I am limitless.
Yep. We are limitless. It's all here. Man, that hustle and grind con changes.
Nothing I cannot be. Nothing I cannot do. Nothing I cannot have. There exists no limits in my mind.
I love it.
I love it.
It's awesome, right? I'll leave the other one ready for later. Yeah, that was pretty good. That is pretty good. That's something you gotta like listen to every day, every single day, and get yourself motivated. Let me see here. My purpose is to help people in many aspects. My ultimate purpose is to help everyone and be successful. Yeah, we have the same purpose, including family. Ooh, that's great, CJ. I love it, I love it, I love it. Hey, Jason May, how are you? He left. So yeah, that's pretty good, guys. I don't know what else you guys want to do because I don't want to get away from the live. I think this is so fun to just be here and chill with everybody. Janelle, how's your Friday? What are you up to? I'm wearing my advanced auto parts shirt. I like to wear it like once in a moment. How's your Friday night, Janelle? I'm closing. Oh, for real? Wow. Oh, what time do you leave? At 9 p.m.? Do you have any clients? Hey, what do you want, Nico? Did you sell any cars today? What is it that you do? I have audio now. Couldn't hear before. Oh, really? You couldn't hear before? Oh, you missed a lot of stuff, Bo. We're talking about purpose. What is your purpose, Bo? Ooh, that's awesome. That is super, super great. 8 cars is strong. That's awesome. So you like this new little thing that I made here? All my colorful purples and stuff. Who is this? Who is here? Ronnie Bradford. How are you, Ronnie? Have a good night, Janelle. Thank you for stopping by. I appreciate it. You're always here and supportive. Hey, Frank. How are you? You know, when I read your name, I always think about Fram Kryptonite. So we're just hanging out here, Frank. We're just chilling. We are hearing motivational quotes, hearing a little bit of chill house music. So, and talking about our purpose. What is your purpose, Frank? To help as many people as I can and change the car industry. Awesome, I love it. So you're doing the purpose of our song, changing the negative stigma of the car business. Have a good time, CJ. Thank you for stopping by. I appreciate it. Hey, Lisa. What's up, Lisa Franco? Cry night for years. Hey, Baron, how are you? Yeah, I read it and I think it's like kryptonite or something. How are you, Lisa? How is everything? Okay, so let's listen to the second motivational quote. Hold on. Let's listen to the second one.
Most people don't ever achieve what they want in life. It's not because they aren't capable. It's not because they lack opportunity. It's not because of the circumstances and events that arrive in their life. Most often, it is because most people never define what they want.
We're listening to motivational quotes.
Most people don't know what they want, and it is impossible to find something when you don't know what you're looking for.
In a recent study, it was found that less than 3% of the population set goals. Only 3% have some direction in life.
Your goals,
only 3% define where they are going.
Let me tell you, if you haven't got a target, you are not reaching your full potential. If you haven't got goals, you will never achieve your dreams, because the chances of you one day falling into your dreams is right around zero.
Some people, I just want to be successful, or I just want to be rich. These are not goals. These are wishes. Wishes do not come true. You must be specific. Know exactly what you want out of life. Learn how you are going to get it, and work until you do get it. Define what you want. What do you want? Write it down and read it to yourself every day. Let it sink in to your subconscious mind.
You gotta get out there and seize your dream. Carpe diem that dream. You gotta say, this is what I want, and this is how I'm gonna get it, and I will do whatever it takes.
Most people won't ever end up where they wanna be, because they never define where that place is. They drift through life with no direction, then wonder why they are in the middle of nowhere. Don't be like that. You know better than that. Be like the very few who know where they are going in life. The very few who have a desire to improve every area.
Yay, congratulations.
Willing to work on every area. Excited at the possibilities. Looking forward to each next level in your life. If your goals are easy to achieve, they are not big enough. Set bigger goals. Goals that excite you and scare you at the same time.
Yep.
If it is important to you, you will make it happen. If it is not, you will find an excuse. How bad do you want it?
That is so good, right? How bad do you want it? I wanted to share an experience that I had lately about this situation, because I was offered a job far away, obviously in another state. And in my heart, like in the very, very, very deep of my heart and analyzing everything, I think it would be a great opportunity for me, you know, to go and actually go to that dealership. But I feel very scared, because I've been all my life here in Florida. I don't know anything about other cultures. I wouldn't know anybody in that particular state. So it kind of like freaks me out. But I've been listening to this podcast called Feed Your Mind with Success. And it makes me think a lot about life, about things, if you should like go and find something better for you, and not just stay in one place just because you're comfortable and that you've been there always, and then you don't know what's going to happen in the places where you don't have any contacts or friendships, etc. So listening to this kind of like gives you like that fuel, so you can actually like go and just go for your dream. It's going to be hard at the beginning, because you have to adapt yourself. But if it's a better opportunity for you, money-wise, mental-wise, and as a career-wise, you just have to go for it, you know? If people trust you to go and take that position and really want you bad to be there, I mean, you can't let the people down, and if the opportunity is good, why would you not do it? So that's something that I've been like patting myself on the shoulder myself, because I freak out about that. And I'm like 70% sure that I will accomplish this. But moving, I just got this apartment. This room where I am right now is actually my office. And I have my room over there, and I have this really nice place, and I have a good job and all that stuff. But this other opportunity, and the second time, hey Lance, I didn't see you were here. Going to the new market can be daunting, but it will take about 90 days to learn the market. After that, you'll be fine. Okay, that's awesome, because I feel like it becomes like your brain starts playing tricks with you and tells you like, oh, you're very comfortable here. You got everything you need. You earn a good salary. You're a salesperson, this and that. But the opportunity that at least four or five dealerships have reached out to me to go to another place. Hey, Sadek. Hey, Chris Falco. To go to another dealership. And this has been the one that has attracted me the most, because the others are to be a salesperson. This is to actually be like a manager of all the internet department for sales outside of the state. So I think it would be super awesome, because I'm going to be able, or maybe even to take the cars to another state. I will be able to talk with other people, shipping, handling like international business, everything through the internet, and having my own team. And that really like motivates me a lot, but at the same time it freaks me out, because I don't know like if I will be able to set my mind right to be in a place where I have not been before, you know what I mean? So it becomes a little hard. But I mean, hey Rich, how are you? So listening to these things like kind of like helps you like redirect your mind to other types of stuff, to see the big picture, to see the future, to see that okay, I'm gonna be with a big brand, and I'm gonna be helping them with all their internet department. But at the same time, as the mind tricks you think to yourself, okay, I'm gonna make this amount of money, but I gotta do all these changes and get out of my comfort zone to actually find that mountain, that new mountain that you're gonna start climbing. Right now we're like in this little hill, everything is cool, but every time you start going up and up and up and up and up, obviously it becomes harder. So you have to be able to be mentally mature to just go for it, you know? And if it doesn't work, we'll have a plan B, have some money saved, and if you have to return back to where you were, always leave the door open for the past jobs, and hoping that doesn't have to happen. Because sometimes, I mean, I don't have anybody that can make me stay here, because I don't have children, I'm not married, so it's gonna be a little bit more easier. But I do hope to have this answer soon, because they're waiting on me and it kind of like freaks me out. So now let's continue. Hey, Lay. Am I saying your name right? Lay, Lee. Let's listen to the last part of the motivation speaker that we were listening to.
Some people say they've set goals, but then they don't take action toward that goal because they get overwhelmed. Well, take that impossible goal and break it down into small action steps you can take. Take action. Build some momentum. Once you get going, you won't be able to stop. You will achieve your goal. Then you can move on to the next level. Bigger targets, greater accomplishments. So you have your goals, you have your plan, the action steps to climb to your goal. Next, you have to define your reason why. Why must you achieve this goal? Find a deep emotional reason, your why, your reason that will ensure you do not back down from this when times get tough.
Yep.
Odds are you've never met a successful person that doesn't set goals. because the chances of finding what you want without a clear target to move toward are slim and none. If you don't know where you're going, you will end up someplace you don't want to be. Setting goals should be the number one priority for anyone seeking success. Define exactly what it is you want, your end goal. If you want success in any area, you must have goals. If you want to achieve anything of significance, you must have goals. Goals are a must. There's no way around it. Not only will they help you achieve whatever it is you want in life, but they will give you life. They will give you a reason to get up every morning. Something meaningful to work towards. That's a goal. When setting your goals, remember, if it doesn't challenge you, it will never change you.
Yep.
Set goals that others think are crazy, that will make you stretch yourself. Set a goal so big that you can't achieve it until you grow into the person that can.
Yep.
Tell yourself, I will achieve my goal. I will leave no doubt in my mind. I will take all action needed to achieve the life I want. Leave no doubt in your mind. Know in your heart, you will do this.
That is pretty good. So, does anybody want to share their goal? Hey, Baron, you came back. Bowley. What type of goals do you guys have? Some people want it to happen. Some wish it could happen. Others make it happen. Michael Jordan. Yeah, this was actually my quote. I used my senior year in my high school yearbook. I still believe it's true. Yeah, that is true. Because sometimes you want to accomplish certain things and certain goals, and we just stay there because we don't know if we're going to be capable to do them or not. And they just stay in the air. And something that I from the stuff that we're listening to, they say like to write it down and to read it every day. Like every time you feel low, every time you have a situation, just keep reading your goal over and over and over, and know that through the purpose that you're trying to accomplish in life, whatever it is, family or whatever dream you have, just read it, be positive, and just make the best out of it. You know what I mean? Just not stay there and wait like for the door to be open when you knock. You know what I mean? So that's pretty good. I like your quote. You should put it in your Facebook. Like to repeat yourself, like to remind yourself about what you want in life. Some people want it to happen. Some wish it would happen. Others make it happen. I love it. It's perfect. It is perfect, Bo. It's an awesome quote. Let me give you a heart there. Hey, Michael. How are you, Michael? That's a good idea. Thanks. Yeah. But put it in the quotes. You know that little thing that you have below your profile pic that's called bio? Hey, Jerry, that little profile pic, there's a little section in the bottom. You can copy and paste that, and I'm pretty sure it's going to look pretty cool. I'm pretty sure it's going to look awesome. It's going to look super, super cool. Yeah, so we're talking about whoever is coming in right now. We're talking about our purpose, our goals, and we're listening to music and we're listening to motivational quotes. Just chilling and relaxing. Nothing fancy, nothing weird. So yeah, I think that's pretty strong. You just gotta write that goal and look at it every day. You know something that I would like to do now that I have this office? I wanna put like a little board. It could be like, I don't know, it could be a whiteboard or whatever board. and write all the goals down and have a big like my favorite motivational quote, just like the one you have, Bo, and put it there and then read it every day. I think that's a great idea. That way you always have it like in your head and all that stuff. Well, besides having it in the notebook, it would be nice to see it like big. Hey, Bo, you stayed all the time with me. Thank you so much. You're so cool. Yeah, a lot of people just stay for a little moment and then they leave. That's cool. So, Bo, what do you want to talk about? It's only me and you, I believe. There's two other people, but I think the other person is not... I have it public, so maybe people that follow me that are not my friends are on.
I step inside this space with you.
I hope my battery doesn't die. What do you want to talk about, Bo? What other things do you have in mind? So what are you going to do to accomplish your goals, Bo? Let me know, Bo. Hey, Jordan. How are you? Why doesn't it pop out that you're here? You want to listen to another motivational quote, Bo? I have to use my iPad to do all this stuff. Setting my goals, not by my biggest one right now. Is that so? Of course. Are you in my group, Bo? Did you add yourself at my group called Facebook Marketplace and offer up training? Because I can train you to get a lot of extra sales a month for free. I don't know if you're there because I think you are. I think I sent you a message. I also did tonight because they couldn't prove their residence. Oh man, that sucks. I hate when that happens. Yeah, I think you are. I think I did send you stuff, but I'm not sure in what video you're on. Have you tried Marketplace already or not? This looks better, right? I look better. Let me see what happens if I do this. Oh. Helps. Hola, Juan Guillermo. How are you? Yeah, this is something that you gotta be super consistent, you know? Yeah, Marketplace is something that you gotta be super consistent because it's something that you gotta post daily and people get to know you and you just have to like post and try to post only down payments of 1,000. And you will get a lot of people talking to you, but it's up to you to really actually get them to go to the dealership. You know what I mean? Yeah, this looks much better. I was in the too dark. It looks nicer like this. Let's hear another one.
You find your passion not from what you do, but why you do what you do. Your motivation isn't gonna come from what you do. Your motivation will come from why you must do what you do.
It's great to have goals. It's important to have goals.
Yeah, it's important.
If you want to succeed at any level, it is essential you set goals. But why is it some achieve their goals no matter how big, but some never achieve their goals no matter how small?
Yep.
Tell me, why is it that some dive deep, head first into chasing their goals, but others seem to be stuck, always procrastinate, never taking action towards their goals? Those who achieve their goals have a powerful reason why they must achieve their goal. Those that fail don't. They don't have a powerful reason. And when you don't have a reason why you must do something, you aren't really likely to follow through, are you? Because there are no real consequences to failure. It's okay to go back to average.
He's
what
right.
Is your reason? Why is that a must? What are the consequences if you do not follow through with this? What is your life going to look like if you fail? What will it look like when you succeed? Hold that vision in your mind. You, after you have achieved this goal, what will it change in your life? How will it improve your character, your relationships, your finances, your life?
Your reason might be linked to a negative or positive outcome. If I do this, how will it enhance my life? What will improve? Who will it help? Or if I don't do this, what will it cost me? How will I suffer? Who else will suffer if I don't follow through?
Your why must be something that makes you move. It is the most powerful reason in your life. Why must you succeed? Why must you change? Why must you take action right now? Is it for your family? Is it for their future? Is it to inspire someone you love so they will be lifted by your example? What is your why?
If you make excuses or procrastinate against doing something, it can only mean your reason for doing it is not powerful or meaningful enough. If it was life or death, you wouldn't procrastinate. You would just do whatever it takes to make it happen.
So find your real reason why you want this so bad. Why do you want this goal? Why must you have it? If you find it, write it down and read it every day.
Yep.
This is your fuel. The fuel that will drive your success train right to your dream life.
Most people are chasing the money, but the money will always run faster. You go and chase your why. You live your why and let the money chase you. The only way you can be great is to live your purpose. The only way to live your purpose is to find your reason why. That's all you need to achieve anything in life. A powerful reason. What is it for you? If your reason is powerful enough, you won't need any extra motivation. Your reason is motivation enough. Think about it right now. Why is it important you succeed? Why?
Motivation will get you going. Your goals will keep you going. Your purpose will drive you home.
And if your why doesn't make you cry, then that is not your why.
Wow. Where are you at right now? Oh yeah, wait until I put more if you want to stay all night with me. This will be motivation night. Maybe I'll do another live called
like
that.
Quitting.
Think about why you started. What was the reason? What are you doing it all for? Finding your reason why is essential if you want to achieve success. If you don't have a strong reason behind your actions are less likely to create quality results. If you do have a strong why, you have all the fuel you need to drive you forward to success. What's your why?
Woohoo! That's pretty strong right there. That is awesome. Yeah, that podcast is really strong. I'll share it to you through Messenger right now. Let me see if I can share it. Oh, but I have to press on it. Hold on. I'm gonna share it right now for you. Hey Josh Martinez, how are you? I sent it to you, Bo.
I got something here.
It's like, it's a little long, but it's good. Now let's get the party started. See, look, I even have a stroker. Woo! See, it's like passive and it goes up, it goes down, it goes up. I used to be a DJ. I was a DJ for 10 years. So that's where like, I like all this stuff, the lights and everything. Alrighty, watch the replay. I'll see you later. Come back later when you put the kids to sleep. I'll be here all night. This is gonna be my longest live ever. I'm gonna go get my charger, guys. This phone is gonna die. haven't read your stuff. Hold on. Let me see. I'm trying to get some people in here. I'm going to read your comments in a second. Let me just read this real quick. Hey, James, how are you? I am trying to find some people.
I got something here.
James, how was your day? Chilling out and putting music and listening to motivational quotes.
Their dream, not because of failure. Most people don't live their dream because they give up.
Listen to
you
this,
see,
guys.
It's not the failure that stops us. but that most stop at their first failure. Those who succeed don't stop at one failure. They don't stop at 10 failures. They don't stop at 100, 1,000, or a million. They say, this is my goal, and I will do whatever it takes to achieve it. I will learn the lessons from any failures. I will learn faster. I will work harder. I will work smarter. And I will not quit until my dream is a reality. That's the difference between success and failure. Failure makes winners stronger. Failure makes winners hungrier. But it makes most give up. It makes most feel worthless. Winners don't enjoy failure, but they would never let failure stop them. Next time you encounter failure, you got to remember every great thing on this planet is here because the Creator learned what did work, but learned more from what did not work. When we are kids, we don't stop at failure. When we first learn to ride a bike, it's failure after failure. We get knocked down time after time, but we get up and push forward.
Hey, Sean, you're back.
Until we achieve our goal of riding the bike. But then we get old, and most of us get weak. We are too soft to get back on the bike. We come up with excuses. It must not be for me. No, you just soft. No, you just
lazy. In my office.
Tell yourself the truth.
In my house, in my office.
Learn why you failed, and make sure you don't fall again. Make sure you are stronger for having the lesson.
Failure is not the end of your story. It is the start of your comeback story.
We're just putting motivational
stuff. If failure was the end of your story, there would be no greats. Greats like Jordan, greats like Einstein, like Edison, like Oprah Winfrey. If these people stopped at failure, the world would not be filled with their greatness as it is today. Failure is nothing but a lesson to the winner. Failure is nothing but motivation to the winner. Failure is fuel. No one likes to fail, but the difference between those that win and those that lose in life is the winner decides a better meaning for their failure. They decide never again. They declare, I will be better next time. Don't let failure stop you. Let it grow you. Let it develop you. Failure is not the end. It's just the start. The start of your comeback story.
Yep.
The only way you can call it a failure is if you quit. If you keep going, it's only a hurdle, one you will overcome. The only way you can fail is if you quit. Never quit. Keep pushing. You will get there in the end. Failure doesn't exist in the mind of champions. All it does is push them to a higher level. Are you a champion? Will you accept failure or keep going?
Yep.
Learn the lessons.
Hey,
apply the lessons. Come out stronger than before and keep going. Some people fear failure so much, they never even try. They never even stop. Some people give up right when they're about to succeed. They were so close, but they threw in the towel. Don't let that be you.
Thomas Edison didn't fail. He found 10,000 ways.
We're listening
ways
to music and motivational quotes.
Guess what? He only needed one way that did work. Einstein said, failure is success in progress.
Ooh.
Failure is just one more way
like
not to do something.
Keep going and you will succeed. Keep going and you will succeed.
Failure is not the end of your story. It is the start of your comeback story.
If you use failure as fuel, you can't really fail. If you use it as motivation, you cannot be defeated in the long term. If you use it to drive you, use it to make you, it can never break you. If you never accept defeat,
hey,
you can never fail. Refuse to be defeated. Learn the lesson. Find a new path and a different way to your goal. There's always a way.
Yeah, there's always a way. Failure is progress in motion. I love that. Yeah, we're invite everybody if you can, Christopher. I'm putting music and putting this type of stuff in the background too. This is very nice. I mean, it's a Friday night and I'm doing this, but I don't care. I need motivation. I got really serious decisions to take next week. Helps us grow. That's about it. You fall one time, you pick up yourself again, and so on and so on. I mean, everybody has had their failures, but it's up to you if you keep, like, you know, procrastinating and not doing them, not doing your goals, not pursuing your dreams. Just stay there. You gotta stand up again. The harder you push, the further you go. Yes, sir. You are right. That is correct. What do you think about the people that when they fall, they're scared, like, to stand up because they think they're gonna fall again? Like, what do you guys think about that? Like, if you know you have a flaw and you keep failing on that flaw, it could be smoking cigarettes, it could be drinking, it could be cussing, it could be bad reckless driving, something, and you know you're failing. What do you think about the people that just stay there and they just don't want to change because they don't believe in themselves and they think that just because they're failing and they have this prototype of person of themselves, they're just gonna keep doing the same thing over and over? I don't know. Hey, Christopher. Exactly. That is so true. You're right. I think that's important to know that every time you fail, you're going to succeed, because that means that if you lift yourself up, you're going to be a better person. Because if you don't get yourself up, you're just going to be there. Like, no motion, no motivation. You don't want to, like, really actually, like go and stand up, no matter if you have some little, you know, like your jeans got ripped off or whatever. You just gotta stand up and continue. Succeeding is that, like, you got something wrong, you stand up and you continue, you know. Hey, Debbie, how are you? Thank you for stopping by. That is good. I like that. What about James? What do you think, James? What is your opinion about failure? Hi, Papa. They need someone positive in their life that pushes them. Yeah, that's correct. I think the hardest part of failing a lot is like when you fail, hey girl, what's up? We're having a motivational party. Yeah, that's how I should have called this broadcast, motivational party. I think that if you don't have that team or that people that help you like actually succeed, you're just gonna stick like to all the bad stuff and you're not gonna like actually progress, because I believe that what everybody says, that the five people around you are actually the people that feed you, or they feed you positivity or they feed you negativity. So for me, thinking about when you don't have those type of friends, it's harder for you to just get out of that bad stuff, you know, because there's no accountability. Like nobody's like looking at you, hey, you're doing this wrong, or how do I help you to improve yourself? So when you got that good team of friends, it could be in the distance, doesn't matter, but even strangers, like they help you. You can't just stick to not like just being stuck and not actually like liberating yourself from all those fears and those things that are dropping you down. I believe the mind is so powerful that you can't just limit yourself to be some person. If you want to be that other type of person, you just gotta go after it. Yes, the support group. Positive thinking won't help you anything, but it will help you do everything better than negative thinking as well. That's correct. That's great. Hey, Faye, what's up, my lady? Okay, let's listen to the next one, okay, guys?
A belief is a feeling of absolute certainty. If you want to achieve anything in life,
good in you,
you need to get certain you will achieve it. You must believe in yourself. Beliefs control results, because you will never take action towards something you don't believe is possible. You can have all the education in the world. It doesn't matter. If you don't believe you can do it, you will never get it.
Do you think Jordan could have become the greatest if he didn't believe in himself? Not a chance. He would have quit when things got hard. He would have quit when he was cut from his high school basketball team. You think Serena would be the greatest female tennis player in history without belief? Not a chance.
These great athletes, great entrepreneurs, great human beings are great because they believe in themselves. They believe when no one else does. They believe when they are down. They believe when they are at rock bottom. This is my dream, and I will succeed. Maybe not immediately, but absolutely and definitely. There is no doubt in my mind. This goal I have, this dream I have, I will get it. I will.
I will.
Beliefs control your results, because you will never take action towards something you don't believe is possible. In order to succeed, you must believe. In order to believe you're good enough, you must be good enough. If you're not there yet, get to work. Work, 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 until you get to the place where you know you will make it. No doubt, no doubt, I will make it, I will get it, I will have it.
Work on your weaknesses until they become your strengths. Work on your flaws until they become your fire. Work on your problems until they become your power.
You have to believe that something great can happen, even if there is no evidence. Believe.
Even pretty strong
if
words.
Others say it is impossible, believe. Even when everything is going wrong, believe. Change your belief that you can't to the knowing
that you can. Change the belief that there are limitations to the knowing there are none. Change the belief that there isn't a way, and push yourself to find your own path, your own answers, your own way. You can't just go off logic. The greatest achievements in the world defy logic. They are born from belief. The greatest achievements did not come from someone who saw what was possible and didn't dare attempt better. The greatest achievements came from those who see what is possible, but still believe. They can achieve something impossible.
So tell me about your beliefs. Tell me about your beliefs. Wants to be somebody. I think that if you believe, you can achieve. That's what I think. I think you need to go to the club. I haven't gone to a club like in years, like decades. I don't go, I don't do that anymore. I was a DJ for 10 years, and that's about it. That was all my life of clubbing. No more. I barely can hear here. I hear better now after the conference because somehow my ear popped, but no. Guys, so let's get serious. I just like the pump stuff. So for me, believing is achieving. If you don't believe in yourself and you don't believe in what you can do, that's the only motivation you can have, because if you just stay in yourself and you'd like think, oh, am I able to achieve this, yes or no, I think you can think that it's gonna happen and, you know, feed up your mind every day and you're gonna actually achieve it. Even though if it becomes very difficult, even though you have to trip, even though you gotta go by yourself, just think about all the accomplishments that you can get out of motivation, believing, and just being a better person. Imagine when you achieve those goals, you just cross them out and you make new goals, and then you keep climbing and climbing and climbing. I think it's awesome. I think our mind is able to do so many things. Hey Paul, how are you? Steven, let me say hello to all these people. What do you guys think about believing? Tell me, what are your believings? For some of us can be believing in God, and God is the source of our fuel to be better. For others, believing in other things can make them accomplish their goals. But what is your belief? Yeah, I like that. Tomorrow has to be a better day. But what if you can do today a better day? You don't have to wait until tomorrow. You can do it today. I think that's pretty good. Jerry, what do you think about Believe? Faye, James, Debbie. Guys, let's make this interactive. I want to start doing these on Friday nights, like staying like 5 hours live. 5 hours. So we do a little pump of music, right? And then I put another motivational quote, and then we discuss, and so on and so on. I think it's a good show. No, I'm playing only chill out house music because we are doing motivational party. Okay guys, let's go to the next one, or does anybody want to talk? Anybody wants to share their beliefs? hello to my mommy. Okay, on a serious note. Oh, you're so funny, Andrea. You're so funny. It's all about what you believe. Yeah. Yeah, you have to believe in yourself. If you don't believe in yourself, you're not gonna accomplish anything. So the next subject, it's gonna be your word. Your word, meaning that when you talk something, when you promise something, you're gonna keep your word. This one is super, super, super. You believe. This one is really good because I fail a lot in this one. When you say you're gonna do something and you don't do it, listen to this quote.
A lot of people talk a good game, don't they? They say they're going to do this and that. But when push comes to shove, they disappear. When it's game time, they're nowhere to be seen. They say they're going to be the greatest ever, but their work ethic shows average effort. They say they're going to be rich or famous, but their habits are poor and ordinary.
Yeah.
Talking is not enough. You must do. Talking is not enough. You must put in the work. You must develop the habit of following through with your word. When you say you're going to do something, you do it. It's called integrity. When you honor your word, you build pride for yourself and respect from others. When you don't, when you talk the talk,
yep,
and never walk, you lose pride and you lose respect. Repeat to yourself every day. If I say I'm going to do something, I do it. If I give my word, I do it. If I talk it, I will walk it. If I say I'm going to do something, I do it. If I give my word, I do it. If I talk it, I will walk it. When it gets hard, I gave my word. If something comes up, I gave my word. I will get it done. I don't even have to think twice. I get it done. I will get it done. Talkers talk. Walkers walk. Don't tell them what you're going to do. Show them what you've done. Let your results speak for you. Results.
Yes, yes, yes. You can do it.
Keep your word. Do the work. Get the results. Game time. This is my word. I've said it. Now I will do it.
That Glenn shared this morning. Because I fail a lot on that. I say, hey, yeah, I will go do this and that, and then I'm like, oops, like I don't remember what I said, and then I don't I just don't keep my word sometimes. So I know I gotta fix that stuff. How can you fix the situation that you talk the talk and walk the walk, but you walk and you don't talk? I'll check Jerry. I don't know. It's from the podcast that Glenn shared this morning, so I have no clue. Faye, I'm so happy you're enjoying it. Debbie, James, thank you for staying all this time. You want to share something, Jerry, or Faye, or Debbie? How can we keep our word? One day at a time. Yep. Lisa, you're back. Guys, talk so it can become nicer. Some topics. Talk about something else. Be honest. Very good. Be honest. I like that. I need Andrea to share one more quote so I can go to the next motivational speech. Okay, let's go to the next one. Transparency is a plus. Yes, that's very true. But sometimes we try to say, there's something that I've noticed, like for example, in my case, like I think that where I fail with my word is that I try to make others happy, you know, like just, oh, say yes, yes, and go with the crowd. And then I'm like, oh no, this is not what I want. You know what I mean? Agreed on a price and drove 2 hours to the customer's house. Got there and he signed on the paper, asked for his checks and he was paying cash. And he said he couldn't move another 500, so the customer told me to get out of his head. Oh my goodness. Wow, that sucks. That is terrible. That is a great example of how to keep your word. I mean, for $500, I can't believe the client said no to you. That's not good. That sucks. But I'm pretty sure tomorrow, Jerry, that you are going to sell 3 cars. You are going to have a hat trick tomorrow, Jerry. You will have a hat trick. I will see it and you will achieve it, and I believe in you, and you will have a hat trick tomorrow. You can talk about it. This is like our little group to talk about it. This is motivational party, so we gotta motivate each other. That's why the music is like, ooh. Okay, ready for another one? Let's go for another one. Tomorrow's your birthday, so you're gonna do a hat trick.
didn't come this far to only come this far. I hear some people saying things like, when I make it, when I get to the top, I'll keep working hard until I get to the top, until I reach my goal. Let me tell you something. There's no end. Winners never stop. If you reach your goal, set a bigger goal. If you get to the top of the mountain, find a bigger mountain. It's the journey, the continued pursuit of growth, the constant seeking of improvement, the challenge. That's what makes life great. That's what makes a fulfilled life. I didn't come this far to only come this far. When I get this goal, I'll seek more. Not more things, more growth. Constantly pushing myself to be better. I didn't come this far to only come this far. I came this far so I could be strong enough to go further. So I'll be good enough to push myself hard. I'm only getting started. This is just the beginning. I'm proud of my achievements, but that doesn't mean I'll settle for them. Proud, but never satisfied. Proud, but forever humble. Proud and always ready. Proud, but pushing. Pushing for more. Pushing for great. A true winner doesn't seek only the title. A true winner seeks growth. A true winner seeks greatness. It's the journey. It's the challenge. Don't tell me it's over. I'm just getting warmed up. If the journey wasn't challenging, the destination wouldn't be rewarding. It's the challenge that makes the greatness. You can't have a champion athlete without great competitors pushing them all the way. You can't have the greatest of all time without champions pushing them all the way. It's the journey, the process that makes the greatness. If you reach your goal, set a bigger goal. If you get to the top of the mountain, find a bigger mountain.
Because you're in the top, you just can't stop. If you're in the top, you climb up higher mountain and you keep going and keep going and keep going and keep going. You just can't stop. That's totally true. If you, life is not about achieving all the goals right away. I think if you just enjoy the journey, enjoy the ride, just be happy and motivate yourself every day, I think you'll be very, very good. I think I'm gonna go December the 2nd because I'm gonna go to a Patron's conference. So I'm gonna be in New York for like a week. I hope this is helping anybody that's having a bad week or a bad month or a bad day to get you a little happy. Oh, you are. That's awesome, Johnny. How was your day? We're doing Motivational Party. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Thank you, Lisa, for all those likes. Woo! Hearts, hearts, hearts. You're having fun, Johnny? I'm glad. This is just a little Motivational Party. I don't even know how long I've been online, but it's all right. That's what it is about. Fat Johnny. You're Fat Johnny. Guys, so what do you guys think about the journey? What are you gonna do so your journey can be happier? You don't climb the mountain to go back down. You just keep pushing up. So whatever you have achieved in life, I believe that whatever you have achieved in life, it's gonna be always there. It's like when you do a resume. When you do a resume and you write all your experience in your jobs, I think the experiences that you have also in life should stay here. And if it was bad, it'll help you grow. And if it was good, let that good stuff motivate you to get better stuff. That's what I see. So sometimes it's hard to get things done because we're all human and sometimes we don't feel like doing anything. But if you keep in mind that when you were low, you were always able to go up, that means you can do it again. You can do it again. Why would you be fearful about maybe having a bad month or maybe having a bad day or a circumstance that happens on the constant, right? If you one time overcome it, you can overcome it two times, you can overcome it three times, you can overcome it four times. So for me, that is something super important when you realize and when you're grateful about stuff, you know that all those positive things can just help you fuel you up, you know? Give you that fire that you needed. I mean, life is only one, right? We only have one life. It's only one time. And I mean, we just have to make the best of it, right? Let me put the next one. You guys ready for the next one? Okay, this one is called One Thing. I like this one a lot. Listen to this one.
It's the little details that count. That one little bit extra, repeated time after time. That extra hour, the extra reps, the extra little bit of effort, that little extra, with consistency adds up to a massive difference. Let me talk to you today about the principle of one thing. Committing every day to do one thing extra that will take you closer to your dream life, closer to that big goal you have. Now, before we begin, it is most important that you first have a very clear picture of your dream life, a clearly defined goal. After all, you can't hit a target you can't see. And you certainly won't arrive at your destination if you don't know where that place is. So take a moment, a day, a week, however long it takes you, and write it down very clearly what your perfect life would look like. What would your health be like? Your energy levels? Your physical body? Define it clearly. What would your relationships be like? Friendships, love, everything? Define it clearly. How much money would you be earning? And how would you be earning it? What would light you up and pay you well at the same time? Be very specific. Now you have your targets. But how are you going to hit them? Let's start by committing every single day to do one thing that will take you closer to each major goal you have in your life, no matter how small that step will be, no matter what disasters and obstacles step in your way, no excuses. Commit this to yourself. This is your life we're talking about. Nothing is more important. make a commitment to go 100% all in. If I'm tired, no excuses. I will still do one thing. If I don't feel like it, no excuses. I will do one thing. No excuses. Commit this to yourself. If I feel it's going nowhere, no excuses. I will do one thing. I can even change my approach, but I will not stop working toward the life I really want to live. The principle behind the commitment is to build momentum. It is also to build a habit of consistency, a habit that you will find in all successful people. It's always just that little bit extra that makes a big difference in the end. Just that one thing done every day that adds up and compounds on itself until one day you don't even recognize the person you see in the mirror. The changes can be that great, but only if you make the commitment. Are you prepared to make that commitment? Make a commitment to go 100% all in. It's the little details that count. That one little bit extra, repeated time after time. That extra hour, the extra reps, the extra little bit of effort, that little extra with consistency adds up to a massive difference. Yeah. One thing, just that little bit extra, that's what separates the hopeful from the lost, the success from the failure. That's what builds character, forms a powerful habit. That's the difference. Just that little extra.
That is powerful, guys. That is powerful. The extra mile. Just one thing that motivates you will not let you fail. Just if you have a very strong motivation, it's just gonna burst out of you. I think that's very deep. What do you guys think? Yes, it is live! Bye, Johnny. Thank you for staying. This is Motivational Party, guys. Aw, thank you. I'm trying to motivate everybody. Yeah, guys, this is pretty strong. Just one thing can take you to the peak and motivate you every single day. Like, make a big sign, a big, big sign that just says that one thing that makes you, like, fire up. And I'm pretty sure that if you have that motivation and that motivation is big, it's gonna be huge for you. For real. And if you come back, you maybe come back as a tree, maybe you come back as a car, maybe you come back as a bus, and you're gonna be like, oh, I remember when I was a human and I didn't do this and this and this and this to make my life better. How can I say this? Just live life to the fullest. And all that motivation, that one single thing, can just change your life forever. Accomplish your dreams. Walk through the journey, even though there's rocks and stones, and you're gonna fall, and there's gonna be people that don't agree with you. You just gotta keep going, keep going. Just don't stick there like, woo, like just walking with the crowd. No, you were meant to be great. And if you're watching this, it's because you're gonna be great. So somebody that's not motivated is gonna find this like boring and they don't wanna listen to it. But if you're here, I'm sure that you've got greatness in your life and you're gonna be amazing. You know Spanish? Wow! I love it. That is awesome. Hey Andrea, you're back. You missed a really good one about one thing that motivates you the most. That is awesome. Andrea, when is your daughter gonna have her baby? When are you gonna be a grandmama? She left again. She left us. She left us. Debbie, thank you for staying so long. You're awesome, Debbie. You're the best, Debbie. I'm pretty sure this is firing you up since you've been here for so long. And Lisa! Lisa's still here. Woohoo! All right, let's do one more. Let me see what's next. Ooh, this next subject is good. Hey, Rio Allen, how are you? Thanks for stopping by.
Inside me that demands more out of life, more than most expect, more than most are prepared to work for. I refuse to settle for an average life. I refuse to conform to what others want for me, others' belief of what I should do with my life. I refuse to be a slave to the system. I refuse to believe in impossible, because I know anything is possible. I refuse to stop working on myself. I will never stop working, never stop growing and pushing the limits. I refuse to give in full stop. My character will not allow me to quit. I refuse to stop believing in myself, even when no one else does. I will not stop believing there is better than this.
Yep.
I know there is more to life than this. I refuse to stop searching for better, searching for solutions. I refuse to stop growing, becoming a better version of myself. I refuse to be brought down to the level of the haters and the naysayers, because I know if they knew any better, they would do better. I refuse to follow others. I walk my own path.
even if that path is not as popular with the majority. I refuse to stop believing in miracles, and I intend to create a few today.
I will not accept whatever comes my way. I will go out and hunt for what is mine. I refuse to settle for average. It might be okay for others, but it's not okay for me. It's not okay for me.
I refuse to be unhappy with my life. I choose to be grateful. I choose to be blessed. I refuse to settle for anything but the best in every area of my life. That's what I deserve. That's what
we deserve the best. We deserve the best.
I've always wanted more from life. Not more things. Not more money. More juice. More life. More quality. I've always wanted to live at the highest level. The very peak of my capabilities. And because I'm always getting better myself, that bar is always rising. Because I'm always growing. My expectations are growing. My goals are growing. My results are growing. I am growing. I will not accept limits. Limits are there to be pushed. I will not listen to the doubters. I will not listen to the naysayers. I will not take on their limits. When no one thinks you can, that's when you have to.
I refuse to be ordinary. I will never settle for anything less than legendary.
What's possible can only be known by those who refuse to believe in impossible.
I refuse to believe in impossible because I know anything is possible. Woo!
Nothing is impossible. Guys, this is awesome. Don't you guys think nothing is impossible? Don't settle for nothing. You will always have the best. The best, the best, the best. And you gotta go hunt. Hunt and hunt until you get what you want. That's all. Nothing else to say. I am a firm believer of that. Hunting, 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 hunting. We're gonna go hunt it together. And we will succeed. We will be the best. We won't care about anybody. Our family, obviously. But it's straightforward. Like, what do you refuse? Like, what is that thing that makes you think that you don't deserve what you want? You gotta refuse to what? Or won't you refuse to anything? That's right. I know. That was a good one. I like that one a lot. I refuse to settle. We deserve the best. We were created for the best. Why just be like the majority? I mean, the money's right there. The achievements are right there. If you have a talent, if you have a purpose in life, you just go for it, you know? Never settle. Yes. You are right. Yeah, we don't want to settle for stuff. It's like when you settle for a job you don't like, when you settle for a relationship you don't like, when you settle to have
alcoholic friends. I don't know. I mean, that moment when you settle is when you're in your comfort zone. So when you're in your comfort zone, you're actually just letting it like sit still, and you're not doing anything to motivate yourself to get better stuff. So, oh, I settle for this job because it's close to my house and it's comfortable and this and that. But what if there's a better job and you gotta commute an hour of driving just to make you a better person or have a better position, right? So, what are you laughing about, Alex? You're silly, Alex. What do you think about it, Debbie? You're not gonna settle, Debbie, aren't you? What about Lisa? No settling. Hello, Robert. Nope, no settling. No, we can't. We have to be strong in our heads too. And not just because we're happy here, that's it. No. I mean, you can stick to the job you have, yes, but you gotta think that that's not it. There's more, there's better things out there. You're funny, Alex. Okay, guys, ready for the next one? Thank you. How are you, Robert? This next one is gonna be good. You guys are gonna love this next one.
When you wake up every morning, what drives you?
When you wake up every morning, what drives
you? If you want to live a life of success, a life of complete success, happiness and fulfillment, you must find your purpose. You see, if you don't know what your purpose is, if you don't know what drives you, what inspires you, then you have no reason to improve your life. How can you improve your life if you have no reason to improve it? Your purpose is always, always something that lights a fire in you. I will do this no matter what. My family is counting on me. My friends are counting on me. I am counting on me. So write down your purpose. Carry it with you everywhere. Feel it deep and promise yourself every day you will live out your purpose with zero excuses. Why do you do what you do? Why do you do what you do? What's the reason? Why do you exist?
What is the reason you wake up every day and do what you do? Is it for yourself? Or is it for the people who need you? Is it for the people who took care of you? And now they're too weak to take care of themselves. So your why shouldn't be because of you. It should be because of the people who need you. It should be because you love them enough to keep fighting.
Did you know, do you not agree, that right now there is someone who has less intelligence than you, started with less money than you, less opportunities than you have, and worst of all, has less passion than you. And they are living their dreams, earning millions, or doing something that you would love to do. Someone has already done and is already doing what you want to do. And no, they didn't fall into a rich family to do so. They were not born lucky. You know you can be more. You can have more, do more, and be more. You know this. You wouldn't be listening otherwise.
Yep.
See, a lot of people, they're gonna tell you not to fight for your dream because they didn't have the strength to fight for their dream. Make a decision today that I'm not doing this for a check. I'm not doing this for a house. I'm not doing this for a car. I'm doing this for my purpose.
When you can't go a day without thinking about it, when you dream about it, wake up thinking about it and can't rest until you conquer it. when you don't mind sacrificing because of it, when nothing is greater than knowing you can conquer it, when you don't need the alarm clock to wake you because it's fueling every part of your soul, then you know your purpose. Your purpose is that fire, your reason for doing what you do. Why do you do what you do? Why do you want that success so bad? What is the fuel to your fire?
Find your why. Your why will pull you up when you feel like you don't have the strength to get up anymore. Your why will keep you fighting when everyone else thinks you are out for the count. Why? Who are you fighting for? What drives you?
Is your purpose your family? Is it to prove the doubters wrong? Is it to prove yourself right? What is your purpose? Write down your purpose. Carry it with you everywhere. Feel it deep and promise yourself every day you will live your purpose with zero excuses.
Your purpose? Find it, and you will have no problem becoming a phenomenal success. Because purpose moves mountains. It moves mountains and opens up doors that didn't exist. It gives you the fire that you need to burn down the world of limitations. The water you need to drown doubt. Your why, your purpose, it's everything. Find it, use it.
You need to find something that drives you. Something that no matter what happens, this part of you does not change. This drive in you does not change. This purpose never dies.
Yep.
No matter how many times life knocks you down, your purpose pulls you up every time. This is the reason I will fight for my dreams. This is the reason I will not take no for an answer.
You know you can be more. You can have more, do more, and be more. You know this. You wouldn't be listening otherwise.
From this moment, there are no more excuses. Turn on your drive, turn on your passion, and turn off your fear. And then you will be successful. Be fearless. You can do this. You can do this. But you must find your why. Why do you want to do this so bad? Why do you want this so bad? What are you really doing it all for? What is your purpose? Successful people know their why, and they have a very clear purpose, a very clear vision. When you know your purpose, when it is clear why you are doing what you are doing, why you want what you want, write it down. Write it down and read it to yourself every day. There is nothing more powerful than a human being with purpose. With purpose, you will outwork anyone and everyone. You will get up early and stay up late. You will give more, do more, and become more. You will not give up when things go against you, which they will. You will fight on. Fight for your purpose, for your goals, for your dreams. Say it to yourself every day. From now on, regardless of the circumstances, I will achieve my dreams. I will achieve my dreams. I will, regardless of any circumstances. Nothing will stop me.
Wow, that one is powerful. I will achieve my dreams. Nothing can stop you. Just be fearless. Just like Lisa Copeland says, be fearless. Oh boy, this is really good, guys. I hope you're enjoying it. It's a little long because this one lasts like 8 minutes, so I stopped it in the middle. That's why I haven't put the music on. But that one is super, super strong. I believe that everything that happens in life has a reason. And sometimes we can change our ways of life, or change jobs, or something happens to us, maybe a sickness, a disease, a death of someone close to us, even a pet. And sometimes these things just makes us like sad and devastated, and like it's like a car when all the, how do you call this? Like your fuel is going down. Bloop, 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 bloop. The only thing that can keep you lit up is why you wake up every morning. If you're waking up every morning just to be like a little robot, like, oh, let's be a little robot and let's go to work and then come back home and go to sleep and then wake up in the next day and do the same thing and doesn't have a reason. I believe that it's like living like a dead life, you know what I mean? Like not actually enjoying what it is. Like there's only one life, we have our two eyes, we have our two hands, we have our two legs, and we're still like complaining and not achieving and not doing because, oh, this might happen or this might not happen, and then we freak out. I don't know. It's a hard situation to think about, but let's finish it up because I think it's gonna be, it still has 7 minutes left.
Somebody's waiting for you to mess up. Somebody's waiting for you to give up. Someone is waiting for you to fall. So when you're challenged by life, what are you gonna do? When you feel like you're at your lowest point in life, will you throw in the towel? Or will you make the moves to be successful? Don't look back. Just remember where you came from. And let that drive push you to go forward. It's not always going to be an easy road. And when you reach success, you won't take it for granted. You'll cherish those moments you had to go through. Those moments you were without. And when you fall down, get back up. Dust yourself off. When it hurts, keep going. Those cloudy days, those storms, telling you to keep going. Those times in your life when you can't see how you're gonna make it. Some things you can't change. You just have to live with. But if you do have a choice, make the right choice.
Because when you're dead and gone, nobody's gonna remember the material things.
Yep.
They're gonna remember the legacy.
The legacy.
That you left because of your why. Ignore the echoes of the doubters and listen to the trumpets of the truth. Don't let the bullets of life hit you. And you lay there and you bleed to death. You keep fighting. You keep fighting for your why.
Your purpose is that one thing that lights you up. It's the one thing that will get you up early. That one thing. When you're doing it, time stops. Your purpose may be something you don't want. It may be seeing someone in your past and thinking, no matter what, I will ensure I never end up like that. Your purpose is always something that lights a fire in you. I will do this no matter what. My family is counting on me. My friends are counting on me. I am counting on me.
We only get one crack in life. What do you want to be remembered for? Tell yourself you want to be great. No, tell yourself that you will be great.
Yeah.
Your why will become your lungs. It will become the reason you breathe. The reason you wake up every single day. So you have to make your dream your addiction.
Do you know what it takes to be great? Are you willing to go the extra mile? I tell you time and time again, you will get tired. But if you have a why, we'll give you that extra strength, that extra foot you need, that extra hour you need, the courage. Why are you different from everyone else who's trying to do the same thing you're doing? What makes you stand out? Why are you so important?
They give up because their why is not big enough. Maybe they don't even have a why, a purpose. But if you have a purpose, something to fight for, to live and die for, then you have the fight in you. You have fight when things get tough, when everything seems to be going against you. When the majority would give up, you became the minority. And your purpose pushed you through the challenge towards success.
Hey, Megan. Thank you for stopping by.
What is essential is that you commit to working on yourself every single day. That you become obsessed with self-development, obsessed with growing your mindset, feeding your mind with positive thoughts every day, feeding your mind with successful thoughts, learning more
anything that is going to push your mind to evolve to the next level. It will come to you if you keep working on yourself. And by the way, your purpose will most likely change over time because we should always be growing and evolving. I like to think of self-development always like fitness. If you want to be fit and strong, what do you need to do?
Exercise.
You need to commit to working out every single day. Otherwise, you cannot grow stronger. If you stop working out, what happens? You become weaker. Yep. The same is true for your mental strength. The more you read, the more you learn. The more you learn from the truly successful, the stronger your mind will become. And the more successful you will become. Like fitness, though, if you stop working on yourself, your mind will grow weaker. Yep. You must make a commitment that nothing is more important than your self-development. Because a stronger you is a better you. And a better you is better for everyone around you. Never stop working on yourself.
Having a motivational party.
It is a daily process, a journey, not a destination.
Don't go
away. Everyone has a purpose. And that purpose is simply to be happy.
The purpose is to be happy.
That guy that wants to be a millionaire, all he really wants is the happiness he thinks the money will bring. That girl that wants the perfect relationship, what she really wants is the happiness she believes it will bring. Everyone is chasing material things, but no one is making a commitment to just stop and make happiness a priority.
Happiness
make it a priority
is your priority.
To always be searching for the best in life. If this means eliminating bad habits, do it now. What is more important? So now you know your purpose. Get out there and work on yourself. Work on your happiness. Make it a priority that your happiness is more important than anything.
To always try to strive for happiness. Do you think we should stop overthinking? Do you think we should stop analyzing others and complaining about stuff? Do you think we should stop being selfish? Do you think happiness comes out of being a person that gives to others? Do you think happiness comes out of love? Do you think money can buy happiness? Do you think a family can give you happiness? Or do you think being alone can give you happiness as well? What do you guys think about that? What do you think about it, Rogelio? Share us your thoughts now that you're here. Hola, Sebastián. ¿Cómo estás, Sebas? Rogelio, we're waiting. Share something with us. We need to love more. Yes, we do. How can we love more? What do you think we should do to love more? Is there something we should do to love more? It's only you, Debbie, and me. There's only three people here. We're only three people, and we're not on camera. Share it, share it, share it. Give unconditionally. Yes, I love that. That is awesome. Yes, us three, Debbie, Rogelio, and Melissa. Because I have it public, so there must be somebody else around there, but I made this long. Maybe I'll start doing this every Friday. It's a little long, but it's nice. At what time do you think I should stop? I might do this all night now. It's already 10:20. I know this is my longest video. Yeah, it is. It is the longest. So yeah, he's talking about love what you do. Love what you do. This one is gonna be good. Do you guys love what you do? Wait, let me see if I can do this right here, there. Guys, do you love what you do? If you love what you do, you better listen to this.
Mark Zuckerberg once was asked how many hours he worked each week. I want you to listen carefully to his response. He said, "That depends on what you count as work. I spend most of my time thinking about how to connect the world and serve our community better. But a lot of that time isn't in our office,
yep,
or meeting with people, or doing what you'd call real work." He said, "I take a lot of time just to read and think about things by myself. If you count the time I'm in the office, it's probably no more than 50 to 60 hours a week. But if you count all the time I'm focused on our mission, that's basically my whole life."
I don't know.
This is important because it illustrates the difference between working for a living and living for your work. The difference between doing what you love and doing something you hate. Between I got to and I get to. That's the difference.
That's strong right
there. Between I got to and I get to. That's the difference. Most people are working for a living. Very few are living for their work. Living for their vision. Living their purpose.
It's not work when you love what you do. You could put down 80 hours, 100 hours a week. No problem. Because there's a level of excitement, a level of passion and desire to always create and improve when you're going after something you're passionate about. It's not work.
You might say, well, it's easy for Mark Zuckerberg. Listen, this applies to anyone. You don't have to be a billionaire. It's about finding something you want to do and creating your life's work around that.
For most, work will take up the majority of their waking hours. Why spend the majority of your life doing something you hate?
It
makes no sense. You might say, but I need to pay the bills. Well, create a plan now, right where you are, and work toward making something you enjoy pay your bills. Money will come when you share what you love with the world.
Mind-blowing.
When your action is infused with your conscious passion, others relate to that. The rewards will come. It won't take long before your passion income far exceeds your have to income.
Oprah Winfrey once said, do what you have to do until you can do what you want to do. That's what you need to do. Instead of watching TV, make a plan. Instead of a night out, put the plan to work. Learn what others are doing to become successful.
Instead of making excuses, write down how you can make it happen. What can you do? What action can you take? How can you get closer to your goal? You say, I have no money to start. Save. Find an investor or many investors. Do whatever it takes to get it started. If you really want to make it happen, you will find a way. If not, you will find excuses.
Make a plan. Work towards living for your work. Work towards working for your purpose. Create a life you don't need a vacation from. That's the goal. There's a better life waiting for you.
Create a life you don't need a vacation from.
Commit and follow through.
We gotta put that quote. Create a life that you don't need a vacation from.
There's plenty of opportunity for you to make a plan and save towards starting your idea. There have been many people start with nothing and create their dream from scratch. Model these people. You are worth this. Never settle for something you don't want long term. Never settle for anything less than you deserve. Sacrifice now if you need to, so you can enjoy later. But never settle now. If you do,
thank you.
You won't enjoy
thank you.
Later.
I love it. This was good, guys. Good, 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 good. That is amazing. I think he nailed it. He nailed it. What do you want to share, guys? What do you want to share? Really, really powerful one. I love this one. I have to listen to it again in my car. It's amazing. I love it. I'm gonna share it to you right now. Wait. I'm gonna send it to you through Messenger. Send it to you. Hey Fidel, how are you? We're having motivational party. We have the chill out house, chill house music in the background, and then we're putting motivational quotes so we can get pumped up for next week. Well, this is not really pumpy, but we have to get a better song. How's your night, Fidel? How was Orlando? How many cars did you sell today, Fidel? Debbie, how are you in the back? I don't hear you, Debbie. Where are you, Debbie? Well, at least you sold one. That's great. Good night, Debbie. Thank you, Fidel. Happy selling for you too. Yeah, I have to go to sleep later too. I think I'm gonna disconnect in a little bit when everybody's not here. 27.5. Wow. Off lease is great to work at then, right? Off leave is a great place to work. You guys sell a lot of cars. You got really good prices. I love it. Andrea, how long are you gonna stay with me, Andrea? How about Fidel? Fidel, how long are you gonna stay with me here? Andrea, do we do one more? Andrea, do we do one more? One more motivational speech? One more, one more, one more? Yeah. One more motivational speech? You're going out tonight. That's good. Well, we're trying to pump our blood here. Andrea, one more or no? Or do we go bye-bye? I've been live for what, 2 hours? How long have I been live? 2 hours? I have no idea how long I've been live. Yeah, I'm gonna give you some motivation, Fidel.
They said I couldn't. They said I wouldn't. They said they didn't believe in me.
2.5? Wow.
They said I couldn't because of my circumstances. I couldn't because of my past. Because it hadn't been done before. I said, so what?
Listen to this, Fidel.
You can complain and remain the same, or you can decide, commit, and work towards becoming someone that no one thought you could be. You can make all the excuses in the world. We've heard them all. But those that get on in life, leave the excuses and look for the possibilities. You might have had it tough. You might have had it real tough. But it ain't getting any better if you live there.
5 p.m.
You have to drop the little story and work towards your masterpiece. You see it so often. Stories of those with almost identical painful life circumstances. One chooses to live in the pain forever, repeating the reasons why they can't succeed, why they can't move on. The other uses the pain as their reason why they must change. They use their pain as strength. They use the people who don't believe in them as motivation to succeed. Not a reason why they
I'll
can't.
I'll talk to you soon, Andrea.
When things don't go their way, they don't say why me. They say, so what?
Thank you, Fidel, for staying.
They say, try me. When things don't go their way, they keep moving forward.
Your family isn't perfect. So what? You failed in your past. So what? You didn't get to go to college. So what? You don't know where to start. So what? Someone did wrong by you. So what?
Most people seem to think that life is against them somehow. Very few understand life
Two
is
hours
challenging.
And a half.
That is all. I accept life's challenge. I plan to work on myself so I can win. Not just one day, but every day. So what they don't believe in you? You don't need them to believe in you. They're not doing the work. You are.
Thank you.
They're not
good
growing
night
and
you
learning.
Too.
You are. They're not committed to your dream. You are. They're not in love with your vision. You are. They don't define your success. You do. They don't decide if you will put in the work required to make it. You do.
Nobody gets a perfect life. Every one of us face different challenges.
Hey, Sandra, how are you?
You're not punishing anyone but yourself with your excuses. You're holding yourself back, no one else. You choose, be the victim or the victor. You choose
Welcome
to be the
to
one
the
who
motivational party. It's almost
of
over.
Their problems, or the one who succeeded despite their challenges. You choose. Successful people don't always feel like they do it anyway. Take the first step. Get some momentum. Don't ever stop working for your dream. If you really want it, you will plan for it. If you really want it, you will work for it. If you really want it, you will sacrifice for it.
That is strong. I love it. So this was Friday Motivational Party.
So what, life hasn't gone as planned? It doesn't for anyone. All the pain, that's in the past. Do you want to drag it into your future too? You have that choice. You can remain the victim and live in the pain for the rest of your days. Or you can drop it like a hot potato and move on with your life. Leave the pain behind and focus on building your future full of possibilities, full of growth. Push yourself. Surprise yourself. See how far you can go with your life.
Woo! Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for watching this little motivational party. Replay. Have a good night.